So I just wanted to, this is my last slide, I just wanted to share what it looks like when you go into our QPL. So the link to search it is at the top there. And what I've shown you here is all 95 products in a list form. And so what you can do is you can customize columns, you can add more data. So you can add like the PPE data, which you see here, photosynthetic photon efficacy. You can add photosynthetic photon flux data. Remember, this is tested data in the worst case scenario. And then you can sort by however you want. So here I've sorted by companies. So as you can see, Fluence Bioengineering has been on the QPL for quite a while. You can sort by model numbers. It obviously makes sense to sort for flux, PPF, or to sort for efficacy. So let's say that you're looking to replace a 1,000-watt double-ended high-pressure sodium fixture, which might have a flux of, say, 1,800 micromoles per second. If you sort this QPL by flux, you can then find all the products that are around 1,800 micromoles per second. Some are higher, some are lower. And then reach out to those manufacturers that have those products on the QPL and ask them to help you with layouts. That would be the next step, or look at their cut sheets. That would be the next step from using the QPL. You can download this, you can save it. You can filter by certain states that actually have cannabis regulations for Illinois and Massachusetts that actually rely on the QPL. You can actually filter for them. And if that comes to pass in Michigan, we will certainly add a filter there to help you out.
Some of these lights are meant for certain physical situations, whether it be in a rack or high bay for lighting a greenhouse or a single level grow room. So the first thing is that you get to know, you know, get your list together of models that you're interested in that put out the right light in the right form factor for what you're going for. And then sort it by, and then you can kind of weigh some of the objective measurements and know that they're apples to apples. And, you know, you can sort basically by, say, I don't want to invest in anything below 2.4 as a PPE. And that's something that it would be a common thing to a customer ask. So I'll sort it by that and say, you know, here are the 10 lights that are meant for rack hanging, and they all must have efficacy over 2.4, and go from there, and yeah, use it as a filtering tool, and to find out about new companies. There are more lighting manufacturers than anyone can possibly keep up with at this point.